Laurel Canyon was home to many music icons who would leave their marks on the world, but there was one in particular who was unlike any other, and the impression he left on everyone he touched was truly unforgettable.
You know, when Frank Zappa first came out, everybody thought he was a clown. Everybody thought he was sort of the court jester of rock and roll. Until you really started listening to Freak Out, and you started listening to We're Only In It For The Money or Absolutely Free, and you realized that he was not just that, he was the maestro. He was actually the guy that every single musician looked up to and said, this guy is an absolute genius.
And right by his side, his female counterpart, Gail.
What do you do for money?
I have a rock and roll band.
Right, so the first time that you encountered Frank, what was the experience like for you?
I was introduced to Frank, and I could smell the peanut butter in his mustache from at least 4 feet away. Okay, so I'm like, oh, this is, I don't know what this means, but here he comes. And he walked over to me and said, you're cute. I was, I think, the term is in love. I don't know how else to describe it.
They were married 1 week before daughter Moon Unit Zappa was born. For a very long 4 months, the Zappas lived at the infamous log cabin at the corner of Laurel Canyon and Lookout Mountain, across from the Houdini Estate.
But you were always amazed to be sitting there, and all of a sudden, who would walk in the door? It'd be John Lennon, Mick Jagger, or Brian Wilson, or the LA Philharmonic. You never knew who was going to be there.
I think we perhaps inspired some of the people who liked what we do to get a little bit looser and a little bit more devious. And as I said before about progress not being possible without some sort of deviation, meet a few deviants.
The great thing about Frank was he would make fun of politics and he would make fun of the establishment, but he would make just as much fun of the hippies and make just as much fun of rock bands. So everybody was fair target for Frank.
But above all else, Frank Zappa is considered by many one of the greatest composers of our time.
He might have incidentally been a musician and a great guitar player, ultimately, and certainly, you know, a wit and all of these other things that he's proved to be. But first and foremost, he was a composer, and there's no way that he could do anything but write music.
Do you still talk to him?
I don't know that I talk to him as much as he talks to me. First of all, I see him in my children. Every day that I see my children, he's there, he's present for me. And as far as him telling me things, you'd be amazed the number of interviews that I've done where if somebody pressed a point that I just thought was vile, they'd go home and find out they didn't have it on tape. You know, it's crazy. But he's rescued me so many times in my life since he's been gone.
So when you drive around this area, does it feel good to you? Does it bring back memories?
Yes, it does. It's strange, but the vibe is still here. You see the place and then you remember all of the different people that lived here, all of the music that came from here. And so it lives inside of your heart.
I can see similar things that were happening in Los Angeles and happening again in other parts of the world. There's a Laurel Canyon in somebody's soul everywhere in the world today.
Those of us that experienced it and survived, it's our responsibility to teach that and to teach peace and to teach about loving other human beings as equal.
In the 60s, artists believed they could change the world with their music. And for a short period of time, in a very special place called Laurel Canyon, they did. For more on today's show, go to abc7.com/ionla. I'm Tina Malave. See you next time.